Greetings everyone again. In this video we leave Coonabarabran behind and head towards the town of Narrabri via the Newell Highway. However, before getting there we do a stop at the Pilliga Pottery and the Aboriginal Sand Caves. Once you get about 23 kilometers north of Coonabarabran, there is a turn off into the Pilliga Forest, which takes you to the Pilliga Pottery. It's only about 10 kilometers long, however, it's not sealed. It's a muddy track with corrugations and ruts when it's dry, and I'm pretty sure it could be awful when it's wet, so be careful when doing this section. We didn't take our caravan down this track as it would have meant a slow drive and 20 kilometers of corrugations and dust everywhere. I'm sure there are people with caravans that have off-road suspension that would be fine doing this track. You could of course do it with any caravan, but would have to drive very slowly and accept a bit of dust in the van and wear and tear on your suspension. So why would you want to go to the Pilliga Pottery in the first place? Well, apart from having accommodation like farm stay and a good camping site, they make pottery and have a nice cafe. Even if you're not into pottery, it was fascinating to see what these artists make from clay. They have a nice shop with lots of items, and then there is the workshop where they make pottery. We managed to time our visit so we got to see one of the artists make a piece. After that we had a cup of coffee in the cafe and walked a bit outside. There we found this amazing pottery tree with lots of details in it. It even has lights, so it would be pretty nice to see in the dark as well. They also have lots of heads of people made out of clay, which I guess are some of the artists and people related to the business. We certainly weren't disappointed with going there, even if we didn't buy any pottery. If you stay there, there are plenty of interesting walks you can do in the Pilliga Forest, in addition to experiencing the pottery making process. The Pilliga Pottery business is also off-grid and wholly run on renewables with their own solar power and water supply. After we got there and walked around, I took a fair few photos and a bit of video which I have put at the end of this one. So plenty to see and experience.